Alright, what is up? It is your boy in here bringing to you guys a brand new freaking video, man. So look, listen, today we got a banger because we're going to be talking about... Thought I saw a deer. Today we're going to be talking about something that is talked about everywhere and is a really big factor when you're trying to buy a truck. And that is, should I get a 4x2 or should I get a 4x4 pickup truck? Now for a lot of people, there is a immediate answer, and if you think about crossing the line with the other answer, may God help you. Now, personally, I've owned both. I've owned a 4x4 and I've owned a 4x2. I'm also gonna help you decide whether you actually need a 4x4 or if you need a 4x2. So we're gonna go over three things, which is price, maintenance, and also usage. Before we get on all that, please leave a like, a comment, and a subscription. We're at 548 subscribers, okay? That is insane. I have been doing YouTube since 2012. That is 8 years. Some people get to 1,000 subscribers in a day. So please help your boy out. I'm trying to get to 1,000. Other than that, man, let's get right into the video. Alrighty, so 4x4 and the price difference that it brings isn't significant, but it's something to think about. So this is a Toyota-based channel, so we're gonna go off of the Tacoma and how much more it costs to actually get 4x4 versus a two-wheel drive model. A 2021 Toyota Tacoma SR5 with two-wheel drive, $31,085, 31K. Let's step it up to the 4x4 now. If you add the 4x4 option, you go up to $34,000. Now, this is the math I just did, $3,340. So that's it. That's $3,300 that you would save yourself if you just get a 4x2 Toyota Tacoma. From what I know in payments, that should only be around $60 to $80 more. It is $60 to $80 more every month that you're gonna be paying. And once you finance one of these cars, if you don't put nothing down, you're looking at a $500 to $600 payment. That can keep you at $600 versus putting you at almost $700. Upfront cost, you're looking at around $3,000. Let's just call it $3,000 flat. So now we're gonna get into something that I don't think a lot of people talk about, nor do they advise you when you're buying these type of things. There is maintenance cost to this, and it's more money down the line. Now, before you go all nilly-willy on me talking about all cars need maintenance, yes, but when you get a 4x4, you're adding more maintenance to your list. So this truck has a standard differential in the rear. So in all trucks, you have a differential in the back. That's what distributes your power to your tires. Every so often, you have to clean that oil that's inside of there that's working everything and keeping everything lubricated. This is done if you're an extreme off-roader. I've heard some people do it as early as 15,000 miles. I'm not doing it. I'm already at 12,000. People say don't go more than 30,000 miles. Now, if you had a 4x2, you could just do the back and call it a day. You also have to do the front if you have a 4x4 truck. A lot of people are gonna be like, well, I don't wanna do it. That's fine, but in the long run, it may not be so fine. But if you don't take care of this stuff properly, then, you know, maybe not now, maybe 2-3 years down the road, when you try to pop this bad boy into 4x4, it may not kick in right away. It may not even kick in at all, just because everything has corroded so hard together. So it's just something to keep in mind. So that's my number two point, maintenance and cost down the line. It's gonna always be cheaper 4x2. If you get with the 4x2, you only have to change the rear diff. More moving parts means there's more room for error. More room for error means there's less money in your pocket. Now we're gonna talk about the third thing, and this is usage, your personal usage. When I had my 2019 Toyota Tacoma SR5, when I had my truck, it always played a part in my mind that I couldn't do as much as a 4x4 could, but I never needed it. If you live somewhere where there's not a lot of rain, where there's not a lot of, you know, weather that can prohibit you from driving your truck, I would say no, don't get it. But if you live somewhere where there's not a lot of weather and there's not a lot of climate that could affect you, and you want to do off-roading adventure, absolutely get the 4x4. Car loans are a big thing. You cannot just change them like you change your underwear. So if you have the slightest idea of taking your truck off-roading or mudding or doing anything like that, please do yourself the favor and get the 4x4. It's $3,000 of a difference. Work a little bit harder and get that bad boy done. It is going to be more money down the line, but that's, you know, the price you pay. I would rather pay more then regret something later down the line. But if you don't need it and you just want it and you feel the need that you're gonna go off-roading, don't settle for the 4x2 because it will bite you very hard. That's about it, man. Let me know if this stuff helped you. I definitely think that if someone would have sat down and explained this stuff to me before, I would be in such a different situation right now. I definitely advise you to listen to what I've told you because it's very important and it's really true. Number one, pricing up front, it's gonna be more expensive to own a 4x4. Pricing down the line, it's gonna be more expensive to own a 4x4. At the end of the day, if you need a 4x4, get it. If you want a 4x4, get it. If you don't need a 4x4, don't get it. That's just my two cents. I hope you guys did enjoy. Remember to leave a like, a comment, and a subscription if you guys enjoyed any part of this video. It's been your boy. I'm outie like an outie. I'll see you tomorrow. Cinco de Mayo. Peace.